the mysterious Coal Nyack region. Definitely one of the wildest, least accessed areas of the park as far as like a big segment. I think some people will put in at the Coal entrance and then come out at the Nyack. Others might do the exact opposite, but this is hike 734 and I needed to get the south boundary trail. So we put in at the Coal entrance. One little side note that I do want to talk about. Oh, thought I slipped on a snake. One little side note that I did want to talk about is there is the Coal Creek trailhead, and that does have a hitch rail, but it's not really great for parking and all that kind of stuff. If you go a little bit east, like I think like a quarter mile to the Stanton trailhead, much better place for horses and all that kind of stuff. So I'd recommend that. That's just a little side note and kind of the little bonus for you. So we went into the Coal Creek entrance, followed the south boundary trail, and then up the Nyack drainage, and then up around Surprise Pass, and up into Martha's Basin, and then came out the Coal Creek drainage. And it's a overall definitely a treed deal. You start out on the south boundary trail, and it's kind of fun because there's the road, the train, the water, and the trail. So I kind of like that. And it's basically just a treed area where you just kind of go up and down for a while. Nothing super crazy. Got some fall colors. And, but kind of what you'd expect in the south end of the park where you'd have, you know, just a lot of trees. And anyways, it opens up to some kind of fun little vistas of the Middle Fork. And then you end up turning up into the Nyack. And also be aware, there's a lot of creek crossings and river crossings. You do have to cross the Middle Fork to even get into here. And so be aware of that seasonally and all that kind of stuff. But you start traveling up Nyack Creek, and once again, loads of trees. You do every once in a while have some views of some of the surrounding mountains. You pop out into an old burn area, and that kind of gives you an idea of what you're looking at. But overall, it's not a lot of views. And then we stayed at Lower Nyack Campground, and that's what I consider a utility type campground where it's mostly just a place to rest your head. And then woke up the next day and started heading back up. And it was really fun to look at some of the Nyack. Nyack is a really pretty creek. There's a lot of really cool things, and there's some nice falls areas where it kind of gets into a little bit of a canyon area, and so that's pretty cool. And you pass a patrol cabin, which is pretty awesome, and then finally you get to Upper Nyack. The Upper Nyack campground is cool because you can camp on the gravel and all that kind of stuff, which is pretty sweet. And then there's the Upper Nyack cabin, which is awesome. And you know, all the while you're getting better views of like Stimson and Thompson peaks. And after that cabin, it's a little bit further to get to the Cutbank Pass cutoff trail. If you take that, you'll go ahead and go up over Cutbank Pass, which is right around in that Pitamaukin, really kind of a cool area. But that is definitely a very steep trail. After that, from that section all the way up Surprise Pass was super, super overgrown and just doing a lot of wading through thick stuff. And just through that whole section, it's just kind of fun because you just get to like little peaks into peaks. Finally, you get up into some good glacial views and the stuff that I really enjoy and what I think of when I think of Glacier Park. And so that's really fun. You get some views of like Flinch. And anyway, so then one of the really cool things was being September this time of year, as we were hiking up towards Beaver Woman Lake, which is where we camped, there is a, we heard a little bugling from an elk, which was fun. And we happened to be heading in his direction, and he happened to pop around the corner, which was great because it was awesome to see this monster bull elk while we were on our way to camp. So then we continued on to camp, and Beaver Woman Lake's campsite is kind of lame because essentially you're stuck out in this avalanche debris area, so it's not very pretty. It's really hard to get to Beaver Woman Lake, and it's pretty, the lake itself is pretty, but there's no real access to it. So you can see that it does look very awesome, and you're looking at Mount Pincho right there, which is really cool. Right after that, the next morning, I went to Buffalo Woman Lake, which is like a mile away. And a Buffalo Woman Lake is amazing. It's got a waterfall at the end of it. It is gorgeous. Anyways, started working our way down, and it's mostly downhill for a long time. It's really nice. It's in treed areas. You're getting some really good looks at the peaks and through avalanche chutes and whatnot. And then eventually you just bust out of this big burn area, and it's hot if the sun is shining. And it was hot because the sun was shining. So it was a nice day, but definitely a lot of sunshine because the burn area extends for a really long time. But really great views of like Battlement Mountain and Mount St. Nicholas and Mount Duty and just a lot of really cool places. So I definitely just enjoyed looking at all those, although Coal Creek is just running through this old burn area. And you cross the creek, I think, 4 or 5 times, and I'm not exaggerating. So be prepared for multiple shoe changes or just walking in wet feet because you don't care. And anyways, you roll out and it starts to kind of flatten out and you're done with creek crossings and you go to a patrol cabin. And after that, you've only got, I don't know, 5 or 6 miles left. And yeah, then you just head on out back and cut across the Middle Fork and you are good to go. And so that is the Coal Nyack region. Mostly treed except for that really burn section and that Martha's Basin. I think if I was gonna come back, it would be for probably for Buffalo Woman Lake, and I would come up the Coal Creek drainage to go ahead and do that. A lot of the other, if you like solitary, this is your place. There is not anybody around unless you bring friends with you. So that is kind of the Coal Nyack region, remote, and there's lots of opportunities for undesignated stuff, and neat place. And yeah, wild, treed, loads of huckleberries, by the way. Just thought I'd throw that out there. So that's my story on the Coal Nyack region.